What makes a great photograph? Hi, this is Behind the Lens with Joel Grimes. Well, I'm Joel Grimes. And, you know, I asked that question about 7 years ago when I started my blog, and that's the very first thing I typed out, what makes a great photograph? And then I kind of answered that the best I could at that time. I've grown a lot since then, and I've been speaking a lot over all over the world, really. So I've kind of keep revisiting that question. And I think we all want to know what makes a great photograph. Well, I hope you're asking that question, because as an artist and someone who's out creating, I hope you're being challenged to say, all right, I got to solve something here. I got to solve this problem or solve this, and you're constantly pushing yourself. I think what happens is, as photographers and we start out, we get really sucked into the technical side of things. And so I ask this question all the time. Does a great photograph, is it a technical process or a creative process? And we know it's really a merger of both worlds. I think what happens though, and when I started teaching a few years ago, I felt like most of the classes or the instructions that I was seeing were kind of addressing the technical side of things. And so when I started teaching, I thought, I'm gonna kind of, you know, emphasize the creative side, and that's what I've been doing, though I love technical things. And I do a lot of techniques, and I share techniques all the time. So I'm not afraid to do that. But in the end, the most important thing is not really learning all the techniques. It's really defining what your vision is as an artist. Once you come up with that, once you decide, this is what I really like, and I encourage people to do this. In fact, I did it over the weekend. Is I go through and I'll look at images and I'll say, I like that, I don't like, I like that. And by going through and looking at other photographers' work, I begin to develop a sense of what I like, a direction I want to go in. And sometimes what I do is I actually capture those images and put them in a folder just for references, and I'll go back and relook at them. I say, this is kind of the theme that I'm kind of looking at. So it helps me define where I should put my energy and my vision. Now, I want it to be me. I want it to be my vision in the end, not a copy of someone else. And so I emphasize that all the time. You are unique, one of a kind. There's no one on the planet just like you. And so with that uniqueness, you go out and create images and repeat that process over and over again, and you build a body of work, and guess what? Not everyone's going to love what you do. Just like you don't love every photograph that you look at. And so there's certain things you're drawn to, there's certain things I'm drawn to, and they probably don't match up, just like music. We all have a different taste of what we like. And so once you kind of get that, once you understand that that's the way the world works, that you don't have to win over everyone, if you go and you build a good body of work and it represents you as an artist and you put it out there, guess what? People will follow you. You'll find an audience that loves what you do. And so that's the beauty of it, and that's why I like the process, is that not everyone loves what I do. And so therefore I went over a segment and I connect with people and I find like-minded people, and that's fun too. So don't be discouraged if someone doesn't like what you do, or you say you submit your work to a jury competition and you don't get a merit. Nobody recognizes you. And in fact, I've had people come up to me and say in tears, you know, I'm quitting photography. I didn't get one merit at this, you know, and I say, well, that's okay. In fact, maybe you have the best images out of all the people that submitted. It's just that the judges didn't seem to fit their vision to what you do. And so they didn't like what you do. That's okay, because maybe those judges were old fuddy-duddy. So get out, create images, build a body of work, repeat that process over and over, and get it out there, and people will love what you do. There will be a group that will love what you do. So don't be, I would say go to my blog, which is joelgrimesworkshops.com. I have a bunch of stuff on there. In fact, I have a lot of my old blogs that I've typed out or written out, and you can go back and revisit those. I'm hoping to post all these blogs on there, and at some point I want to have hopefully 20, 30 of those that you can go back and kind of cruise through them. You can also find me on joelgrimes.com. That's my website. I have, I would say, my best select images there. And then on Facebook, it's Joel Grimes Photography. On Twitter, it's Joel Grimes Photo.